Welcome to the Grog Shop. In this video, we'll be talking about compost and using compost for your garden or to make compost tea. Either way, this video will be applicable. So now, if you're going to grow organic, and you should, and of course organic means not using man-made fertilizer or insecticides in your garden and fruit orchards or whatever you might be growing, compost is really a must. Compost is like the foundation of it all. With compost, you get all the good nutrients and organic material that continues to break down and feed microorganisms, which are by and large beneficial. And using compost, you can make compost tea to further keep adding natural fertilizer to the soil throughout the growing process. If you have soil compaction like clay soil, compost can help it drain better. If you have sandy soil, compost can help retain moisture. It also helps balance pH levels. The list just goes on and on. I mean, there's really no question about it. You just pretty much have to compost. And besides all that, it's environmentally sound. It's nature's recycling plant, and the little bugs and critters do all the work for you. So pretty much it's compost for the win. In our household, we use the bin and heap system. So we have a little bin in our kitchen and a couple of big heaps outside. I kind of like this bin here. We still have an old beater plastic bin, but we're thinking about maybe upgrading to something like this. If anybody's tried it out, let me know in the comments below. I'll link that in the description. So here you can see the two big heaps. We have one that's open for processing or accepting new material, and that would be the one on the right now. And then the one on the left would be closed for processing. In other words, we're taking compost out of it to use in the garden or to make compost tea. And as you can see, it's almost used up. So of course, there's other ways to do it. You could just get something like this plastic drum that you rotate. You don't even need a bin in the kitchen. You can just carry your scraps out directly, put them in the drum and rotate them. So clearly one big advantage of these drums is it's easier to turn the compost, which is something that you have to do. The heap system requires a little more elbow grease. I'll share the link to this one below. So of course, when you put your compost onto your heap, if you're using the heap system, you want to make sure to cover it up good with some good carbon containing materials. Leaves would be a good example of that. I mean, carbon dominant material. So you have greens and browns is what people call them, but it's browns are carbon dominant and greens are less so. They have more nitrogen typically than the browns, but by keeping some browns on top, you keep the odor down. And it's almost like a protective layer for processing. Okay, so what about all the technical details, right? Yeah, I'm gonna leave that up to some web pages. I'll put some links to a couple of my favorite ones below. One is this University of Illinois page where they talk about things like, you wanna get a higher temperature in certain cases, but you don't always need to reach that 160 or whatever. Talk about how great earthworms are and just other details on the science behind it. And then this one's a little more of a layman's term type page, but I like this page. They break down the ratio. They propose a 2-to-1 green to brown ratio for a batch pile, and then a 1-to-1 ratio for a add as you go pile, which is kind of how I do it. But then you can see all the different types of plants that qualify as green or brown and what type of waste would be green or brown, and etc. I'll put links to both of these below. I think they're pretty helpful. Of course, there's other sites out there as well you can hit up for more details. So yeah, everybody talks about hot composting, getting your pile up to 160 degrees. But there's also such a thing as cold composting, where basically you don't really worry about the temperature and you let it cook. It might get a little warm. You don't necessarily have to monitor it, but everything does eventually break down. It's good to have the heat for certain reasons, like killing weed seeds and whatnot. But you can always use an oven to pasteurize if you need to. Now, if you want to be real technical with your pile, you can get one of these compost thermometers and monitor the temperature of your pile. And I'll put a link to this one below, but they can be helpful if you're into that. That's just not how I do it. I found this quote from this guy on a forum, and it's pretty simple way to go. You know, don't worry too much about all the details. If it smells, you have too much nitrogen, add some browns and give it a toss. If it's not warming, you need more greens, add those and give it a toss, and et cetera, et cetera. I like that approach. It's more or less kind of how I do it. So yeah, here you can see I'm turning the compost. This is how you do it in a heap. Little elbow grease. Like I said, you want to get the wet stuff on top and dry stuff down below. You use a shovel, pitchfork, cultivator, pretty much whatever you got, but it can be a little bit backbreaking sometimes. An alternative way I found to do this is to use an auger on a cordless drill. Basically, you know, the idea is you want to aerate the soil, try to get some of that wet stuff to move up. So, of course, this isn't as effective as turning the whole pile with a shovel or something, but it is effective at getting air down into the compost, which can be pretty compacted with moisture, and that tends to slow the whole process down when those microorganisms can't get the oxygen they need to operate. So this basically keeps you cooking at full speed.
Oh, it's an old lemon or something.
Well, after I dump my compost bin, I always like to rinse it out and take that dirty water and just put it right back on the compost heap. If you have one of those nice stainless steel bins, it should clean up a lot better than this old bucket, but not quite giving up the ghost yet. We'll keep going with it. Okay. So speaking of keeping your heaps wet, you may want to consider automating the watering process. That's what I've done. I basically put some quarter inch tubing around each side, so each big heap has two misters. I got these flexible drip misters hooked up, and that works out pretty good. I'll put links to these misters below. If you can turn it while it's watering, even better. But basically, you want to get that water evenly distributed throughout the pile. Those decomposer microorganisms depend on water and the organic material to be dissolved in water in order to process it. That's how it's done. Thanks for watching.